Hey everyone, it's Ashley. Welcome back to my channel. I am back today with some new Catherine Pooler release products, and this is the Going Batty portion of the Kind of Batty release. If you remember yesterday or my previous video, I showed you the layering stamp sets that are in this release, and today I am showing the Halloween or Going Batty stamp sets and dies that are in the Going Batty portion of the release. So as you can see, it's got some really great stamp sets, these really cool background stamps, the bats and the spiderweb, and the coordinating dies to the Everything But the Broom and Sleepy Hollow stamp sets. And the stamps themselves are pretty tiny, so it's so nice to have those coordinating dies. This here is the Who's There cover plate, and that's what I'm going to be working with today. I sometimes have a little bit of trouble with cover plates because there's really not too much you can do on a card with them. All the cards that use them tend to look a little similar to me just because the cover plate is the entire length and width of the card. So today I'm going to be making a paper lantern for Halloween out of them, or a paper bag lantern. So I've cut two of those out with some midnight cardstock, and I'm going to be cutting just a standard lunch size paper bag, and you want to make sure that that folded part is on the left of the blade, and I'm going to cut it to about 5.5. I cut it just a little bit shorter than that, and that's just because I want the black cardstock to be slightly bigger, just so that you don't see the paper bag from the top. So the measurements of this is 5 inches wide and 3 1/8 on the side. So each side is 3 1/8. And then the height of it should be about 5.5. Again, I did it just slightly smaller so that the cardstock or the lantern cover, when we make it, will stand just a bit above it. As you can see here, you can barely even tell that it's any taller. I just wanted to make sure that you couldn't see the paper bag above it, but if that's something that you wanted to see above it, then definitely cut it a little bit longer. This is a standard 8.5 by 11 size piece of Catherine Pooler midnight cardstock, and I'm going to cut it down the middle at 5.5, and this will make sure that it is the same length as those two pieces of cardstock that we used with the cover plate die. So I'm going to cut it at 5.5 this way, and so now we have a 5.5 by 11 inch piece of black cardstock. And what I'm going to do here is cut this. So I need to do a little bit of math for this, and I've done it for you, and it shouldn't be that hard, and it's not, but for me it was a little tough. Math is not my strong suit. So how I did the math was that I just had to take the side here, which is 3 1/8, and I wanted 1 inch on either side, and this is how I'm going to connect everything together to make it a cover. So I need to cut two pieces at 5 1/8, because 3 1/8 plus 1 inch plus 1 inch is 5 1/8, if that makes any sense. If it doesn't, I promise it's correct. but if it does make sense and you were following along, then you understand what I'm talking about. So I'm putting this on my mini scoreboard here, and I'm going to score this at 1 inch, and then I'm going to just rotate the cardstock and score it again at 1 inch. And this just makes it a little easier. I don't have to measure 3 1/8. I can just do 1 inch on either side, and I'm going to repeat this again with the second piece of cardstock that I cut, and these two pieces of cardstock are going to go on the sides of the paper bag, and I'm going to glue the pieces of cardstock that I cut with the cover plate over them, so it'll overhang a bit, but you won't be able to see it because there is a little bit of a margin on the left and right hand side of this cover plate. And that's how we're going to create the cover for the paper bag with those really cool eyes peeking through once we put the tea light in there. So I'm just folding these and getting these all set up, and I'm just showing a little preview here of how it's going to be. So basically I'm putting these on either side, like I said, and then I'm going to glue that cover plate die-cut piece of cardstock as I'm doing here, just with the thin margins on either side. And I'm going to take those folded pieces of cardstock, and I just want to make sure that I don't see any of the cardstock hanging through those eyes. You want to make sure that it's just right on the edge, because the eyes being open is what's going to create the light from the bag once we put it over. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my bag, and I just want to make sure that I take the creases on the sides out. If the creases are hanging in a little bit, it will obstruct the light coming from the tea light. So that's why I wanted to make the cover just slightly larger than the bag itself. I'm going to take a battery-operated tea light, and I just got mine from Target, but I'm sure they have some at the dollar store that you can find or wherever you like to shop, and I'll place it right in there. You could even do two if you really wanted to give it a little bit of a brighter look, but here is the finished product. I've made a few of these so that I can line my walkway when trick-or-treaters come, and I think it's going to look so cool. But this could also be really great as table decoration or just party decoration if you're having a Halloween party, and I think that people will be really surprised when they hear that you made it yourself. As always, links to my blog, Instagram, Pinterest, and all of the supplies used are in the description. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. Please let me know if you decide that you want to give this a try, and I will see you very soon. Thanks so much. Bye.